One day, 3 days, 1 week, 4 months. I can't even remember the times I go in and out of that place. It feels like I'm the main character of a TV series that every season I got killed and thrown away by somebody. My heart always wanted to be someone better, but my mind manipulated me. I didn't choose this path. My path chose me. I get high whenever I want. Shots after shots. Sip after sip. Drugs after drugs. I'm obsessed over my drugs and pleasure. Not until I saw her. My new obsession.
You also feel what I'm feeling. You also think what I'm thinking. Do you think pink can be blue, and black can be white? Is it okay for girls to be masculine, and for guys to be feminine? I'm about to graduate and still confused over these things. Confusion makes me want to experience new things. That's why I accepted the real me and become unapologetic about my gender. And now, I have the confidence and freedom to rule my life. Not until V, a friend, I guess. I mean, she's always there for me, but I have a feeling that she's using me. You know, drugs.
Pretty, face of the class. Sexy nerd, top chick. What else? Do you still have anything to offer? Is that all you got? Confessing, courting, asking me for a date, showing interest? I have no time for that.
Captain, womanizer, popular jock, heart of the campus, effortless, handsome, strong in every way. He's a lovely talker, but behind all his sugar-coated lines exists a devil, a manipulative and possessive abuser. He hated his father so much. He feels pressured and anxious every time he's around. He wanted to be free, but he can't. That's why he puts all of his anger to Marceline, his girlfriend.
Marceline. Girl's type. She's bold, tough, has a high level of confidence, and a party animal. She has been abused by Gael emotionally and physically ever since the start of their relationship. Gael controls and manipulated her in everything she does. She gets hurt. She cries. But she don't want to let him go. She thinks Gael is her protector, even though he cheated with her own best friend. Sydney seeks validation from men. She thinks when a man likes her, she's on top of the world. She's powerful and unbeatable. She likes Gael, her best friend's boyfriend. She betrayed her best friend because of her selfishness. She thinks she's right in everything she does. But in reality, she just wanted her hands clean and her conscience clear.
Ano? Ah, ba't na naman ba na kay Kael? ko na sa'yo, Ate Sydney, wala kang mapapala dyan dahil simula pa lang, alam mo na kung sino talaga siya.
Siya lang yung nakakaintindi sa akin. Kung tutuusin, dapat ikaw nakakaintindi sa akin. Dali ko yung kapatid ko.
Tigilan mo na yan. You should know about girl code. Especially, boyfriend siya ng best friend mo. Hindi kita maintindihan, nakakalungkot ka.
You know when you stand in front of a light that produces shadow? Hi, that's me, the shadow. No one knows me, cared for me. No one understands me. No one even remembers me. My sister is the light, and I am the shadow. Everyone forgets about me. I'm sick and tired of being me. She didn't just hate her brain though. She hated her body. Not every part. Just her shoulders, her arms, her hands. Also her chest, her stomach, her thighs. Her knees were the worst. Plus her ankles and her big fucking stupid feet. Nobody liked her as a girl. She is prone of bullies. She thinks she's ugly. She pushed everyone away. She thinks people only makes fun of her.
Thank you. So, saan tayo gagala?
IDK!
By the way, you think Kyle is cheating on me?
Ha? Huh?
Sabi ko, you think Kyle is cheating on me? Tat, naririnig mo ba ako o hindi?
Yes? Ano ulit yun?
Ang sabi ko, you think Kyle is cheating on me? You know what? Never mind. I'm just kidding lang naman.
Hindi ko kayang hindi sabihin sa'yo.
Huh? What do you mean?
Kael is cheating on you with your own best friend, si Sydney.
Ano ang sinasabi mo?
I'm telling the truth. V told me she saw Kael and Sydney yesterday. Sinundo ni Kael si Sydney. Listen naman, I'm telling the truth.
Are you serious ba talaga?
Yes.
Well, hindi ako maniniwala hanggang hindi ko sila makamukulong dalawa. I have my own eyes.
Sometimes, when everything piles up together, it is just too hard to carry. Sometimes, it is really hard to keep it going. That's why, sometimes, you do bad things to yourself. It's okay not to be okay. It's okay not to keep your cool. It is okay to stay true to yourself, but it is not okay to hurt yourself.
Obsessive love, or obsessive love disorder, is a condition in which one person feels an overwhelming obsessive desire to possess and protect another person, sometimes with an inability to accept failure or rejection. Sometimes this type of love doesn't just affect the person, but also affect everything around them, including their friends.
No matter how strong you are, how tough you act, and how positive you think, sometimes the world is too heavy to carry. The ocean is too deep, and the desert is too wide to seek. Life can be very hard, and life can be unpredictable. I can be very dumb and say, I had enough. wanted to keep her safe. I wanted to be there for her. I wanted to help her, but it was too late. She tried to end it. She tried to end her life. I wish I was there. But it wasn't.
Pwede mo buksan yung pinto, Alvin? Sagutin mo ako! Hello? Vee, buksan mo yung pintuan! Sagutin mo ako! Hello?
Please. I know what you did, Ti. Talaga si Olive, sarili mong kapatid.
Para mo nalaman yan?
Di na mahalaga. Sagutin mo ko.
Wala akong choice, Isa. I needed to be selfish for once para makuha ka. Dahil buong buhay ko, nagpaka-selfish ako para sa lecheng Olive na yan. Please, Isa, nagsisisi ako. Patawarin mo na ako.
Bitawan mo, nasasaktan ako, Olive!
Hindi, hindi kita bibitawan. Akin ka lang!
Fuck!
A little over an hour and a half ago, apparently the driver of this particular vehicle, what looks to be a white Hyundai sedan, traveling eastbound on Baseline Road from Fruit Street, somehow lost control, went across a lawn, threw a...
I'm sorry.
Best friends, share a laugh, memories, and inside jokes. They spend most of their time together, enjoying life. We cry and laugh at the same time. Best friends stay together forever. But people always leave. Even those people who said they would never leave.
Sige, kailan nga eh.
Kala ko pala akong pera, tapos di pa ako nakapagpa.
Sa'yo mo lang akong pera.
Ikaw, sama ka?
Oo, sama ako.
Ay.
Ayaw nga pala, gusto niya ng juice.
Sige,
okay,
sige.
Okay pa ako.
Sige.
Dalang kayo.
Oo.
Thank you.
Top one and top two. Battle of the fetus or battle of the vultures? Ishan, the smartest guy in class, the top notcher, best student, fine man, really good presenter, and does a great job in everything he does. He is a good son, well-behaved person, and a respectful man. He does a really good job at home and outside. He is a great person, and he worked hard for it. Chris, the smartest girl in class. She tries so hard and tries her best, but it wasn't enough. She can't beat Kishan, no matter what he does. For her parents, grades is everything. She needs to be the best and the best only. She tries so hard, but it wasn't enough. And it will never be enough. She needed to use her money to be the best. And she does. Smart pants. They are always together. Knowledge makes Ethan smart, while money makes Chris even smarter. In the world full of lies, only the wealthiest stays the best. Different stories, different lives, racing with the time, hell they fight, under the same moon, under the same sky. Some survive, some still try, some lose, while others cry. Some give up for others' life, all stay with hope and strive. See yourself as a phony little thing, holding little brother, but yet we complain, blame for time. Time doesn't stay for those who blame. It's in your hand and head, for tick and talk to play the game. And then walking through the valley of shadow, the thoughts in head, I look up and all this happened, still. Under the same moon, under the same sky. Do it!